Hey guys, it's Pastor Ronnie. Welcome to Raw and Real, and today we're going to tackle another one of your tough questions. I always define sin this way. Sin is a real need fulfilled in a wrong way. And in the Bible, sin means to miss the mark. So, if you're struggling with lust, which lust is not looking, there's nothing wrong with looking. If you're single, you should be interested in the opposite sex. You should find people attractive. That's not sinful whatsoever. But if it goes to that next level where it becomes sexual and perverse, then you have a problem according to the Word of God, because Jesus made it clear that if we look on someone with lust, then we've committed adultery in our heart. So we need to make sure that we don't fall under that category. But just like any other sin, if you're struggling with lust and you're single, first you have to own it. And that's one of the biggest issues we're dealing with right now in the United States of America, is we want to redefine sin, and you can't acknowledge something that you think is okay. So the first step to being free from lust is to own it. Own the struggle you are in the midst of. You can't deal with it if you don't own it. So the Bible says we're to flee from fornication. We're to flee from lustful thoughts. So how do we do that? Well, we own it, number one. Number two, we confess it. Yes, we have to confess our sins, not just to God, but to one another. Number three, I would advise you, if you're struggling with lust, to get some accountability. In the old days, we called those accountability partners. The Bible says in James, we're to confess our sins one to another. So you have to have people in your life that you can trust with the issues of the heart. Now, you can't trust everybody, especially people in church. There are people who will use your struggles as a way to gossip and stir things up. You have to have covenant brothers and sisters in your life that you can trust. And once you have discovered those, then they can provide accountability for you. Listen, I've been in ministry 15 years, and I have accountability partners. I have people over me that I talk to about my personal struggles, the mistakes that I made. Yes, I make them too. So when we're in the midst of a struggle, we own it, we confess it, and we seek accountability. And I believe if you'll do those three things with the Word of God and the Spirit of God, you can be free from lust. Well, obviously, if you have a struggle with lust, we've taken a number of people through deliverance here at Abba's House, and some personal friends of mine, even pastors, have really dealt with pornography and lust and all kinds of things in their past. And when we travel, even on a mission trip, they will give their remote control to someone else on our team because they don't want to be tempted to watch pornography overseas. They don't have access to home computers. They have accountability measures. There are all kinds of different programs that you can put on your PC at home that will provide accountability for you. So yeah, I mean, if you're struggling with that, you don't want to watch things or listen to things that stir those feelings up in you, that make you want to go back to a time in your life where that was acceptable. So I would just say, you have to be a light in a dark world. You can't ignore everything, but built-in accountability at home until you can really walk in the freedom that Christ has for you is key. Accountability. But yeah, you want to stay away from watching things or listening to things that are going to take you back to that temptation. Hey guys, thanks for subscribing to my YouTube channel. We want to encourage you to share this with your friends. Hey, we need some questions. If maybe you have a biblical question you want us to try to tackle in these few minutes, submit those in the comments and we'll try to get to your question next time. Thank you so much for connecting with Ronnie Phillips Ministries International. This is Raw and Real. We'll see you next time.